Hello from the Hilltop. Welcome to today's Alumni Career Services webinar sponsored by the Georgetown University Alumni Association. I'm Sarah Smith, Senior Associate Director of Alumni Career Services, and I'll be facilitating today's webinar. I'm so glad to see so many of you on the line today for the Georgetown School of Continuing Studies Professional Certificates Open House. Thanks for taking the time to be with us today and to have your questions answered. Before I introduce our presenters and get today's session underway, I'd like to share a few webinar tips and reminders. Today's webinar broadcast is being recorded, and the webinar recording will be made available on the Alumni Career Services YouTube channel within 48 hours of this broadcast. Our panel of enrollment managers will take your questions at the end of this webinar. You may send in questions and comments as you have them using the questions area of the GoToWebinar control panel. And finally, if you're having any technical difficulties during the webinar, please submit those concerns to me directly via the questions area of the GoToWebinar system. Without further ado, I'm pleased to turn things over to Julia McGinn, Monique Singleton, and Shawnee Sutton, our enrollment managers from the School of Continuing Studies. Thank you so much, y'all, for being here with us today.
Thank you so much, Sarah. Hello, everyone, and thank you all for joining us today for our webinar in professional certificate programs, or our open house today. We're so excited to have you. We have a wealth of information for you all to take a look over. And of course, if you have any questions along the way, please feel free to ask them as you go on. Myself, Julia, and Shawnee will be happy to answer any questions that you all may have. Let me introduce myself. My name is Monique Singleton. I am the Associate Director of Enrollment Management here at the School of Continuing Studies. And we are super pumped to get started and show you all of the certificate programs that we have to offer. And I'll pass it on to Julia for her introduction.
Hello, everyone. My name is Julia McGinn. I'm another one of the enrollment managers here at Georgetown School of Continuing Studies. I'm so happy to be here to share with you also with the information we're going to be providing in this webinar. I oversee a lot of the programs within the Institute for Transformational Leadership. If you have any specific questions about that, I'll be happy to answer them at the end of the webinar, and I'll pass it along to Shawnee.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shawnee Sutton. I'm also an enrollment manager with the professional certificate programs, and I will be a great resource for you all today with any questions that you have. We have well over 28 certificate programs, and we look forward to answering any questions that you have. I preferably oversee our professional certificates, not the executive leadership ones, but open enrollment and any other application programs we have. And look forward to answering your questions. And again, thank you for joining us.
Great, I'm gonna go ahead and share a video produced by the School of Continuing Studies that gives an overview of the certificate programs.
Hello, and welcome to the Georgetown University School of Continuing Studies virtual open house for professional certificate programs. My name is Jeff Warner, and I am the Director of Professional Certificate Programs. I am joined today by my colleague, Susan Finn, who is a member of our adjunct faculty and teaches several courses in the project management program. Welcome, Susan.
Thank you, Jeff. It's a pleasure to be part of this virtual open house. This is really an important opportunity for prospective students to learn about our programs and have your questions answered. Our enrollment team will be answering questions live, so type in any questions you have throughout the webinar.
This is a very important point, Susan. If you are joining us today and have questions regarding our programs or processes for enrolling in any of our programs, our experienced staff are here now to answer your questions and help you begin the registration process. Susan, you have been teaching at Georgetown for several years. You teach courses in the classroom and online. From your experience as an instructor, who is the typical professional learner in our courses?
Jeff, what I found is that there are no typical students. They come from the DC region, across the United States, and from around the world to study at the School of Continuing Studies. They may have completed their bachelor's degree or are continuing their studies after earning a master's, doctorate, or graduate degree. Each professional learner is unique in their professional and personal goals. They may be seeking a Georgetown certificate to advance in their current career path, change it, or for intellectual growth.
Susan, would you agree that the diversity of the professional learners in our classroom contributes to the rich dialogue and educational experience?
Absolutely, Jeff. The diversity of our students and faculty are at the core of Georgetown University's global identity. As a student, you will find yourself a part of an international community of scholars. Our students all have one thing in common. They understand the value of knowledge and lifelong learning in obtaining their professional and personal goals.
If you're joining us today in our virtual open house, you probably are in the process of selecting which university best fits your professional and personal needs. Consider these five factors when making that important decision. First, Georgetown University is one of the world's leading academic and research institutions, offering a unique experience that prepares our students to be global citizens to lead and make a difference in the world. We are a vibrant community of exceptional students, faculty, alumni, and professionals dedicated to applied learning.
Second, we live and work in a global economy. The School of Continuing Studies is recognized globally and attracts professional learners from around the world. More than 300 international students representing 75 nationalities are registered in our courses.
Third, consider who will be your instructors in your program of study. At Georgetown, our faculty are distinguished professionals in their respective fields. They bring both scholarship and real-world experience to the classroom.
Fourth, consider the format of your classes when you make your decision. You will find small class sizes at the School of Continuing Studies. You'll experience individualized attention, interactive peer learning, and the opportunity to easily network with other professional learners and instructors.
And finally, consider the importance of continuing your education and using real-world examples in order to reach your professional goals. At the School of Continuing Studies, you will gain practical, in-demand skills that can be applied immediately. In addition to teaching at Georgetown, Susan, you are an author and consultant. Your clients include nonprofit organizations, government entities, and Fortune 500 companies. From your perspective in working across economic sectors, what do you see as the benefits of a professional certificate from Georgetown University?
Jeff, speaking from my personal experience as an alum, a faculty member, and a certificate holder, continuing professional education is critical to remaining relevant and competitive in today's ever-changing job market. In a recent report from the World Economic Forum, it was noted that by 2022, no less than 54% of all employees will require increasing competencies and refreshing your skills. The skill sets required in both traditional and new occupations will change in most industries and transform how and where people work. Professional certificates offer many benefits as you prepare for the transformation of the future of work. Our professional certificate programs at Georgetown are really ideal for people who want to achieve more immediate academic and career goals. For instance, a certificate can also be the gateway to an advanced degree. You can gain knowledge in a new subject area, stay current with developments in your field, acquire new skills, or learn the latest technology. A certificate in a specialized area represents knowledge, accomplishments, and competencies. Employers today are demanding more specialized education from their employees than ever before. a certificate from Georgetown builds professional credibility.
And here's a list of our available certificates. But in addition to these, professional learners have the option to design their own certificate to match their individual professional and personal goals.
Are you ready to make the decision to earn a highly respected credential from Georgetown University? Here are some questions you should consider as you get started. What do I want to study? How do I want to study? On campus? Online? Intensive formats? What are my payment options? These are just some of the considerations. If you have specific questions, contact our team. How do I get started? Register online for open enrollment courses and certificates. The majority of our professional certificates do not require an application, although some do. Jeff will go into the application and registration process in more detail.
Most of our courses are open enrollment. Here are the steps in the open enrollment process. 1. A bachelor's degree or the equivalent is required to enroll. 2. No application is required for most programs. 3. You have the option to combine on-campus and online courses, if available, to complete your certificate. And 4. Most students register for all courses at the same time, or you may choose to register for courses one by one over time. Several of our programs do require an application, and here are the steps for our application process. Step 1. Each certificate has a unique set of requirements. Please visit our website to view the requirements for your certificate of interest. Step 2. You will complete the online application form. Step 3. This online application may include submitting your resume and CV. Make sure you submit your documents in PDF format. And step 4. You may also be asked to write a statement of purpose explaining your professional and academic skills and accomplishments as they relate to the program of interest. Again, please ensure all your files are submitted in PDF format. And lastly, step 5, a non-refundable application fee if required to process your final application. To assist you in reaching your continuing education goals, there are several tuition and payment options available to you, including scholarships, no interest payment plans, third-party billing, education loans, military benefits, and discounts. For detailed information about the payment and tuition option that will best fit your needs, please contact our enrollment team at the email address provided in these slides. Susan, I want to thank you again for joining us today.
Jeff, it was my pleasure, and I look forward to seeing all of you in class.
Our enrollment staff are available for any questions you may have. Thanks everyone out there for watching today.
Super. So that gave a great overview of programs available, how to apply, et cetera. Julia, Monique, and Shani, any additional words of wisdom to share before we open it up for questions?
Absolutely. So the application-based programs that we have for the fall, all of our fall cohorts, they close today. So if you are interested in any of the fall application-based programs that we have, if you've taken a look at our website or during the presentation, if you went to our website, or even after the open house, if you take a look at our website and you see any programs that you're like, oh yeah, I want to go in the fall, I'm ready, the application deadline is today. So if you're having difficulties, you can't get everything in tonight by tonight, and you start an application, if you need any additional time, please, please, please feel free to text, or not text, but email us. I'm going to send the email in the chat so that everyone who is interested in a program and may or may not complete it by tonight can send us an email and let us know if you are interested, because we know that it is extremely short notice. And if you are new to our programs, one day may not be enough time. So I'm going to send the email to everyone so that if you don't get a chance to complete it by tonight, let us know and we can give you some additional time to complete your application. Maybe a few additional days, the end of this week or the beginning of next week for the fall applications that are available right now.
Awesome. Thank you so much. And everyone be on the lookout for that information in the webinar follow-up email. I'll be sure to share additional ways for you to ask your questions as well. In terms of questions, feel free to send in your questions using the questions area of the GoToWebinar control panel. Ladies, a question that we've received that I'm sure you're getting frequently, but is kind of, tied to the times that we are in terms of building new skills to add to resumes during this time, how do you recommend, considering a certificate program? How can it help to maybe for those who are currently furloughed or who are job hunting or who are looking to attain new skills? Can you just speak a little bit more to how it can help sort of in the current pandemic environment?
Sure, I'll answer that one. So in reference to your resume, are they asking specifically for the application-based program, or how can a certificate enhance your resume currently?
Yeah, how can a certificate enhance your resume currently?
Yeah, so we have, majority of our students are coming from, they've been in the field for some time. Some of them are career changers. So they're looking to either enhance their resume in a way that they can inspire others in their current organization to then get a certificate or to bump up in their current career, or they want to add it to their resume so that they can switch career paths. So it really depends on which path you're on, but not only does the skills and the knowledge, the classroom environment that you're going to be getting, all of the students in your classroom and how rich the conversation is, but you're also going to be getting subject matter experts in our faculty members. Not only do they work full-time in the field that they are teaching, but they also teach at Georgetown University. So you're not getting faculty members that are solely paid just to teach, but they actually work in the field in which they are teaching. So you have that opportunity to speak with the faculty members and get additional information about the field so that you can feel more comfortable with the field that you're interested in. So not only will you be getting the faculty members' knowledge, you'll also be getting the enrichment from the classroom, but also Georgetown University looks really good on your resume as well. So it definitely helps in terms of adding a certificate program to your resume. We get the question often about, is it a certificate or is it a certification? Can I put additional letters behind my name? It is just a certificate program that you'll be getting out of our programs. So you wouldn't be able to add any additional letters on the end of your name, but the skills and the knowledge and the competencies that you'll be receiving from the certificate can definitely enhance where you are in your current career or if you're interested in changing careers.
And just to piggyback off of what Moni just said, also from the presentation, they stated that it gives you professional credibility. So if you decide to, during this pandemic, during this time, you want to enhance on your skills, or you're looking to just jump into something different to get some tangible technical skills, apply skills for something new or something that you just want to advance in, that's where our certificates fit in. And that's where, a lot of employers are looking for employees who have those applied skills that they're looking for. So that's where our certificates come in and help you when they say professional credibility. One of our most popular certificates is our project management certificate, where We have people come from all genres and they want to just get this skill set because it is something that you can use for any in any industry, because you always want to have, you know, that project management background to make sure that you stay on budget, or to say, you know, make sure that your project is on task with everything. So you need that skill set for any job training or any field that you're working in. But just for our certificates, they come in as that actual applied skill set that you can use in a job and what employers are looking for.
That's great. Thank you so much. Can you speak a little bit to the format that classes are offered in? I see there's the flex option. Obviously, with the pandemic going on, things are going to be remote for the time being. Is that right? And can you just speak a little bit to what the format of classes is? Is it a little bit flexible in terms of your schedule, or are there hard and fast, you know, classes held at certain days and certain times?
Sure. I'll speak.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
I can get it, Shawnee.
I'll let you go ahead, Julie.
Oh, all right. So we have two different options right now for the formats of these classes. Right now, everything through the end of the fall semester is going to be virtual. Anything that was in person is now being described as flex learning. And flex learning is different than traditional online. Traditional online is asynchronous. You log in when you can, do the work when you can. It's very deadline-based, self-paced, self-motivated. You turn things in by a deadline. You don't have to log in at a certain hour. You don't have to be logged in for a certain number of hours. It's just turn things in when they're due, and that's it. Very time management oriented, self-paced, self-motivated. And then there's flex learning, which is the alternative for right now, while we're all staying safe at home during the pandemic. So flex learning will be live, synchronous Zoom sessions. That's going to be exactly the same as an in-person class. It'll just be through Zoom. So you'll log in at a specific time. You'll be there for a specific number of hours. There'll be small breaks. Don't worry. There'll be a lunch break, but you'll still get to see your whole class and the professor. You'll be able to raise your hand and be called on, since there'll be a webcam interaction. The professor can break you out into groups and call you back to the main classroom, etc. So this is how it's going to be for the fall semester. We do not know how the spring semester will go, but we're preparing for it to be online just in case. So once we have more information about the spring semester, we'll post that to the website. For this, it's also very flexible. You can mix and match whether you want flex learning only or online only or both. You can take up to 2 years to complete any of our certificates that are not application based. So you can spread out the courses as much as you need to. There's payment plans for if you have everything within one semester, so you can utilize those. But and we also have intensive sections, which were mentioned in the video. And the intensive sections will be only offered in flex learning formats or in-person formats whenever we go back to in-person. And those ones are intensive in that you are completing an entire certificate within the span of about 2 weeks. So it'll be 1 8-hour class a day for about 2 weeks, only on weekdays, but then you've completed the certificate. So it is intensive, but a lot of people will want that for like the summer times, especially for project management. If you wanna get one class done in one day, you can do it. That's most of what we have for right now. And once we have more information about the spring semester, we'll post it on the website.
Wonderful. Thank you. Yeah, I'm sure things are fluid, but that's great to hear that at least fall semester is determined how it's going to be. And then I'm sure spring will be looked at closely and information will be out there when it's ready to be shared. A question about the size of the cohorts that are in the professional certificate programs. How many students are in them usually? And then a question too about ages of students. Does it vary? Do certain certificate programs seem to, you know, go lend themselves towards a certain level of experience or a certain age? Can you just speak about that a little bit?
Sure. So in regards to age, it definitely varies. We have a younger audience for project management, but they range. It can be anywhere from
you know, 25, 30, all the way to 50, 60 years old. Our older audience is typically in the executive leadership certificate programs, like organizational consulting and change leadership, leadership coaching, facilitation. Our older audience tends to go in that direction. But we have a wide range of ages. As soon as we have some that, you know, as soon as they get their bachelor's degree, they may go into a field and say, okay, I just want to go somewhere where they have just a few months. I don't have to stay for a master's degree or a longer period of time. I just want something short term, evenings and weekends, and then I can be finished. So we have 20 somethings all the way to about 60 something in terms of age. And the first part of that question, what was it again?
The size of the cohorts who are taking the certificate, doing the certificate programs at a time, how many students are enrolled at once on average? Yeah.
So the size of the cohort, the maximum is 30 for most of our programs. The open enrollment programs, of course, if only, let's say about 12 or 15 sign up for that class, then we will still run the course. So for open enrollment, it's a little harder to tell how many are going to be in your cohort as opposed to an application-based program, because there's actually a process of applying, being accepted into the program, and putting together a diverse cohort for that application-based program. But the maximum number for majority of the programs that we offer is 30 students.
Great. A question about how prospective students can reach out to alumni of the program, or if that's an option to hear about students' experiences and to learn more kind of about what it's like to be a student in these programs.
Yes. So we have student ambassadors that we call them student ambassadors that are students who've actually completed some of our certificate programs, and we connect students with them. We also have an app called Unibuddy, where it's a service that we have for students to actually reach out to us if they want to talk to us, you know, directly, or meet with or speak with a alumni. We have alumni that are signed up for it that you can actually go on to the Unibuddy. You will have to make an account, however, in order to start the conversation, but it's more of a direct personable touch where you can actually reach out to alumni of a program and actually talk to them directly, or you can reach out to us and we can actually connect you with an alumni of the program. We get this all the time. We know that students, they love to hear the enrollment side and the academic side, but they also love to hear the student experience. So that is something that we do pride ourselves on, having our alumni reach out and work with us to do that, to just give that personal touch to our prospective students.
That's great. And so if people want to be in touch with alumni of the program or in touch with these student ambassadors, is the best way for them to do that to reach out to one of you three?
I think the best way will probably to reach out to us, if, because Unibuddy, you will have to create an account. And I know it's more steps to go through when you're trying to just get, you know, a person directly. But if you're comfortable with Unibuddy, we, by all means, use it. But I think the best move would be to contact us directly at the email address that Monique provided and ask us, you know, to connect you with a alumni or our student ambassadors.
That's great.
I just saw that the email address went to organizers and panelists only. So, Sarah, if you can send that along to everyone who is still attending the open house, that would be great. But the email address is pdcprograms@georgetown.edu and itlprograms@georgetown.edu. So for the Institute for Transformational Leadership, our executive programs, and then the remaining certificate programs. Thank you. I see it switched to all. So now everyone has the email addresses. If you have any additional questions or would like to speak with someone who has completed the program, please email us and we will connect you to someone who's willing to share their experience.
That's great. Thank you. And yes, I will share those email addresses in the webinar follow-up email as well. A final question just about the variety of programs that you offer, certificates you offer. I mean, there's certainly diversity in the programs offered. How do you decide what to offer? And are new certificates coming up available over time? Or, you know, if people want to do something and there's not a certificate for it, is there, you know, a process for figuring out which one is the closest to it? This person wants to know a little bit more about kind of the creation of the certificate programs and you know, how often new ones come up for enrollment.
That's a fantastic question. So we have a great team of academic enrollment, marketing, and we all pretty much come together and talk about different ideas. And from the enrollment perspective, we speak with you all first. We are the first point of contact for majority of our prospective students. And they say, hey, what about a nonprofit? Or what about this type of certificate program? What about HR? Do you have anything in reference to this? So we're always bringing to our team different ideas that, you know, that anyone has in terms of a new certificate program. So we are always looking at our programs, evolving certificate programs that currently exist, and then removing certificate programs that may have low enrollment or there's simply no interest in them any longer. So it's always with these flexible certificate programs, evaluating and changing new programs, but majority of the ideas are coming from you all. If you see a program that you're interested in and Georgetown doesn't offer it, you typically let us know and we will let our team know, is this something that there is a market for? Is it, you know, will it fit in any of our buckets? Will we need to create a new bucket? You know, what is the demand for this program? So I think we're always taking a look at our programs and trying to make them as attractive as possible and just trying to relate to what is currently going on, but still making sure that we have that that professional certificate. We don't necessarily want to be a certificate full of trades, so to speak. Like, we don't want a certificate in construction or something that will give you a trade, but something that will enhance your career and still be considered a professional certificate program. Shawnee, I saw that you unmuted for a second there, if you wanted to add anything to that.
In conjunction to that, we have a great team that actually, as Monique mentioned, work together to make sure that we are staying above, you know, the curve and the market. We also take time, our program team takes time to actually revamp the programs that we currently have to make sure that we're meeting the demand. We also have a corporate education component, well, a custom education component that sometimes fit the needs of people if we don't offer a program that really is tailored to what you want. Sometimes you can merge things together, or, you know, if your organization wants to send a group of people to our program, for instance, our project management, that's my favorite, a project management program, but you want to have it just for your group. We work with our custom education department for that. We also have options to do that within our department as well. So we try to stay above and ahead of the curve when it comes to demand. We, like Monique said, we also take everything that you say to us if you're looking for something. And if we can't, you know, accompany you, but that we try to work with our custom education to see if there's something that they can do. But we do our best to make sure that we try to meet all demands when it comes to this market of professionalism. And yeah, that's all I had to say about that.
Wonderful. Thank you all. Those are all the questions that we received. Any final words of wisdom or advice before we close out today?
Yes, I want to say that if you guys are looking to just revamp a skill set that you already have, or if you're looking to start something new, try new technology, for instance, data science. That's a program that we offer. We also have two new boot camps that are ready to start. We have webinars that are coming up for those. Digital strategy management and data analysis. If you guys ever, you know, are thinking about new ways to just revamp or new ways to get new applied skills, our professional certificate programs are always the way to go. You can look at any events on our event page to sign up for any of our webinars. But we also have professional workshops where we have speech writing, screenwriting, which is also a fun one. We have those as well. So you can take a look at our professional workshops as well. But our programs are always great when you're trying to just get that applied skill, something that is tangible that you can use at work tomorrow. That's what our programs are here to do. And if you guys have any questions are looking to do that, I really recommend you checking out the professional certificates at the School of Continuing Studies. And thank you guys so much for listening to us and joining us. And thank you for all your questions.
Yes, thank you all so much for joining us today. Just to piggyback off of what Shawnee said, on the events tab, we do have webinars for our boot camps that will be Thursday and Friday at 12 o'clock if you're interested in those webinars. And if you have any additional questions, concerns, if you have any additional questions or concerns, definitely call, email. We will be happy to assist you all and take advantage of the application-based programs that are open. And in addition to that, the 10% alumni discount that we offer, make sure that you all take advantage of that. If you are an alumni, if you've completed a certificate program in the past, or if you have completed a degree program at Georgetown University, let us know. We'll be happy to add that 10% designation to your account so you can use it prior to checkout for your certificate program. Thank you all for joining us, and I hope you all have a fantastic week.
All right, one more thing before we go. I wanted to piggyback off of what both Shawnee and Monique said. Again, if you guys start any of the application-based programs, any of those applications, and you can't finish it today, just let us know via email. We can help you out, give you a little more time. And if there's any application that requires a letter of recommendation, your recommenders will have a whole extra week to submit their letters of rec. So you don't have to have those in your in hand right when you register. You can always save and return to them later. As long as you start it, and if you have any problems, just let us know. We'll help you out. Thanks so much for joining us today, everybody.
Thank you for being here with us and for presenting and answering all these questions. And again, just sharing all this information with our Georgetown alumni community. We so appreciate it. I will be sharing this information in the webinar follow-up email, so please be on the lookout for that. The recording of this session will live on our Georgetown Alumni Career Services YouTube channel, so you can tune in anytime or share it with anyone who's interested in the programs. Monique, Shawnee, and Julia, thank you all so much for speaking with us today. Wishing everyone a wonderful rest of the week. Hoya Saxa.